But so far, we've only talked about evaluating single models at a single point. There are also levels to these performances. So for any model, we have four levels of performance. The first one is performing, either it's performing well on the training set or not. And then the second one is performing well on the validation set. And then we have performing on a test set. And finally, we have performing in the real life. So this could be integrated to an app, on a website, or any other way that people might interact with this model. If you remember when we were talking about overfitting, one of the solutions we said that could work to stop overfitting was early stopping. So early stopping, what it does is stops the training process before it is able to overfit. But if you also remember, I mentioned that early stopping is not really suggested because it really confuses the training of the network, the validation of the network, and even the testing of the network. Because once you do early stopping, you are not letting your model to fully train, and then you're validating a model that has not been fully trained, and also you're testing on this model. So basically, early stopping binds all of these steps together. But whereas what we want to do is to have completely separate sets that do not really have a strong effect on each other, so that if there is something wrong with the performance on the training set, we know what to do. That will not affect anything else. If there is something wrong with the performance on validation sets, again, the actions we can take are completely separate, again, with the test set, for example. So that's why, again, I want to reiterate, early stopping is not the best approach to take if you're overfitting. But quickly to tell you what these things mean. Performing well on a training set basically means matching a human's level at this task. It doesn't always have to be matching, but at least getting closer to it. So you always take a human's performance on a task, and then you strive to at least meet it. And sometimes it's even possible to surpass it, but we'll talk about this in a second. It's quite simple to understand what it means to perform good on a validation set or perform well on a validation set. It is in comparison to the training set. Same with the test set, it is in comparison to the validation or general training performance. But what does it mean to perform well in real life? So that basically means you have satisfied customers. Just a couple of examples. If you are a Formula One fan, you might be familiar with the fact that AWS, Amazon, is giving Formula One some insights. They are calculating insights such as how long is it going to take this person to finish this lap, or how many more laps can this driver ride on these tires before they need to change to new tires? But generally, the impression of Formula One fans is that these insights are not very accurate. The insights might say this driver can only drive 10 more laps, and the driver ends up driving 20, 30 more laps with the same tires. So people are not very happy with these insights, and they don't really take it seriously. Whereas, if you're using TikTok, you might be aware that they have an amazing algorithm that does a great job at personalizing their video feed. So if you go there and if you train the model a little bit just by watching 10 to 20 videos, all of a sudden it is quite aware of what kind of videos that you like to watch and what kind of videos you don't like to watch. So that is an example of a AI system that works in real life quite well. So while we're learning this diagnosis step, what we're doing is basically to understand in which level is this problem occurring. As I said, we want to keep these levels separately. So we want to see, is the model performing well on the training set but not on the validation set? Okay, then there's probably going to be some solution that we can come out with there. Or maybe it is performing quite well on training and validation and test set, but it's not quite performing quite well in real life, so we need to come up with separate problems. So basically, this is the goal of this lesson, to understand how do we understand where the problem is and how do we come up with a plan to solve this problem.